Hi, Mark Gordon, on Tuesday, November the 15th, 2011, with your Gold, Silver, and Spiders report. This is the GLD, and we're up against a little bit what I call a head wall here. You can see that there would be a trend line drawn across the tops here, and we're just starting to poke through that here. So this could mean that we're going to run higher here, maybe back up to this upper trend line, which would bring us back up into the, 179, 180 level. You notice that the volume has been falling on this bit of a pullback here, which is a good sign. It's a little consolidation. And you see the 10-week moving average here, this gray solid line coming in for possible support here. So I would not be surprised if gold tries to make a run back up here. And on the positive side, we are up above this blue solid line, which is the 50-day moving average. We did get a pullback here and found support near that line. And also, the 21-day moving average is pointed up and following up along this lower trend line here. So very bullish in that respect. Like to see some volume come in as, as some buying hits the market, hopefully, as we push up higher. And scrolling down to a couple of indicators, we notice that the MACD is in a bullish formation, headed higher with the black line above the blue line, a good sign there. And we notice that the stochastics are still above 80, and they have been for quite some time here. Whenever the stochastics get above 80 for 3 days in a row or more, they're said to be locked in, which is a great sign, which means that we could run much higher. So we had locked in stochastics here for last several weeks, another bullish sign. And moving on to silver, there's something very interesting happening in silver. We are now pushing above the 50-day moving average for the first time in quite some time. This is a very bullish action here. Volume has been light, however, not a very convincing move yet. But the fact that we are above this, if we close above this today on the SLV, that would be a very bullish sign. Your next stop, of course, would be the convergence of these moving averages here, the 100 and 200-day moving averages at about $36, a little under $36 here. So you'll notice the nice flag pattern forming, and if we break above this high here, 34.39, I would expect to move up here. And moving on now to stocks, this is the S&P 500, the SPY. And notice we have a flag formation also forming on the SPY here. Kind of still stuck in this trading range here, below the 200-day moving average, this black line here. This is going to resolve itself one way or the other. But we have been kind of waffling in between some moving averages here. So there will be resolution here. Volume has been light, suggesting a consolidation in this area, of course, after making a big move here in October. So stocks kind of stalling here, and going to find a direction here shortly. Now, when I move on to a weekly chart of the SPY, you'll notice that there is a area of overhead resistance here. If I draw a line along the tops here, this is potentially not a good thing for the S&P 500. If we cannot clear above this upper trend line, then the odds would favor that we go back down. And this would be a very bearish sort of rounding top formation. That would head us back into early 2011, the formation here. Of course, if we can clear that, that would negate this trend here, and our next stop would be back up in the new high area, in the $135, $136 area. So the resolution of this, this flag triangle formation is very important at this juncture. Okay, that's it. Good luck trading.